It is a beautiful day. It is sunny outside. It's like 85 degrees, so not too hot, not too cold. Monstax just released the English single of the year last night at midnight. And also YG Entertainment is continuing to suffer, and nothing makes me happier than seeing Yeon Hyun-suk and his brother suffer. Oh boy, it is a big day. Remember yesterday in that video I posted yesterday? I filmed it 2 days ago, but that video I posted yesterday where I said that I would probably be back way too soon with a YG video. This is that YG video that is way too soon. But you know, I couldn't just ignore everything that's happened in the past 24 hours since that video came out. So yesterday there's been a lot of like news that's come out about the YG thing since then. It has been revealed that Han So-hee is, who's this person? She has been involved in drug scandals before. She almost debuted in GFriend, and then she decided that she didn't think they'd be successful. You know, whatever. they proved her wrong. She didn't think they'd be successful, so she left that company, joined YG Entertainment as a trainee, was supposed to debut with YG, then she got caught up in the TOP weed scandal, and then yeah, anyways, so she is revealed to be the drug dealer that BI was talking to, Hanbin was talking to. That has been a thing. Also last night I like tweeted and was like, hope I wake up to news to YG being put in jail tomorrow, and because it seems like lately I've been waking up to like one new YG Entertainment like scandal thing, information thing every single day. And this morning I woke up and at first I just saw that YG, Yang Hyun-suk, this guy, the guy with the hat that we all know is face of YG, he has been revealed to have left YG. He resigned. He was not kicked out, he was resigned. I feel like that wording is very important in the grand scheme of things. He resigned because of everything going on. Also, his brother, who is like the actual CEO of the company, I believe his name is Yang Min-suk. I know his name is Min-suk, but yeah. Yang Min-suk has also left YG Entertainment. So in the past 2 days, we've had BI, Yang Hyun-suk, and Yang Min-suk leave YG Entertainment. This doesn't feel real to me, to be honest, to be 100% honest. It still feels like I'm gonna wake up tomorrow and I'm gonna see YG's stupid face on a new like reality program or elimination program he's decided to create that he will not debut the group of. Like, it has been so freaking long that I said this in my past video, that I wanted YG to get what he deserves. It's been so freaking long ever since, gosh, when did I like actually start hating YG? Because if you don't know, when I first got into K-pop, Big Bang were my ults before I ulted Super Junior and Infinite, and then I unulted Big Bang. I have a whole video about it. I'll go ahead and link it up above. I think I started hating YG when, because I was, 2NE1 was the first group I ever saw debut when I got into K-pop. They debuted like around the time I got into K-pop. And because I was so into Big Bang, I got into K-pop through G-Dragon's music and then found Big Bang, because, you know, how can you not find Big Bang through finding G-Dragon? It's like, you know, whatever, especially in 2009. And 2NE1 were the first group I saw debut. So they were one of the first girl groups I was really introduced to. Whenever I saw the kind of way that he treated both Big Bang, as far as releases go, as well as comeback periods and rumors, and like, I don't even know when all of this started, but it's been a good, I want to say at least like 6 or 7 years that I have been waiting for YG to get his, and he finally did get his, kind of got his. So they're both out of YG Entertainment, but fun fact, in my past video, I think I did mention it, I don't think I edited that part out. In that video, I talked about how Yang Hyun-suk has the most shares in YG Entertainment. So he, you know, in K-dramas, when there's a big company problem and they're trying to find a new CEO and you have all of these like people sitting there, they're shareholders. They are people who have a say in the company because they own shares in the company. Yang Hyun-suk has the most shares in YG Entertainment. You don't have to be an employee of YG Entertainment to have shares in YG Entertainment. So he still has those shares. And I think Yang Min-suk has the second most shares. I'm not sure about that part. I do know YG has the most shares in YG Entertainment. So what does this mean? This means that they still have a huge say in everything that goes on in YG Entertainment. They're not really out of the company. They're out of the company, but they're not out of everything happening in the company. If they ever decide to vote on a new CEO, which I'm sure is like the first thing on their list, is try to find someone new to put in charge. YG and his brother have a big say in who gets to be the next CEO. So that doesn't feel right with me. The best thing that can happen right now is police. I know that there's still connections with the police, and I'm not sure where this is gonna go now, but more and more information is coming out about YG, and Han So-hee has said like there are more idols under YG Entertainment who are involved in this drug scandal. She's just crazy enough to spill all of the tea. I watched Sam's live last night. I watched part of it. She was talking about YG. I will go ahead and link it because love her lives. They're so good. When I catch them, I'm so excited because I love her lives so much. Yeah, she was talking about how she wants BI to just kind of come out now that he's out of YG Entertainment and say, this is all the information I know, this is everything I know, this is all the bad stuff that's going on behind the scenes. And I feel like BI might be a little too scared to do that. I can't fully, like, it would be great if he did that, but I can't fully see him doing that. What I can see is I can see someone like Han So-hee, who literally has nothing to lose. Like, she's from a wealthy, well-to-do family. She obviously gave up being an idol back when the TOP thing happened. Like, that's not going to happen. She's no way she's going to debut. And she just doesn't seem like she cares. Like, she keeps coming out with all this information saying like, I will give it all to you. I will give you all the information. Because I feel like someone like Han So-hee just wants all the attention. And she will give all, I'm sure she knows a lot. And now that it's started to come out and her name is out there, I feel like she will, even though she has her own like, you know, own things that she probably should be charged for, but besides that, so I think that someone like Han So-hee is the perfect person to spill everything under YG, because she literally does not care. It doesn't seem like she really cares about what happens to her. It's all about bringing down YG at this point. And you know, she may not be the hero we were expecting, but she is the hero that we needed. So she's annoyed me before, but for now I will accept her. I don't know, the shareholders need to choose a new CEO, which I'm most worried about. I do hope that police investigations start for Min-suk and Hyung-suk before they do that, so that they cannot have a say in, they need to like give up their shares to the company. That is the next big step that needs to happen under YG Entertainment for things to continue to move in a positive direction. This is a good step, but it's not the end, if you know what I'm saying. There's also Seung-hoon from Winner texted Han So-hee, this is another thing that's come out, asking if she had heard from BI recently. That's really the extent of the text messages, but now that someone from Winner is involved in this, it's like obviously multiple people in the company. So I just want to touch on Somi's debut super quick, because even though this isn't really directly involved and she's under the Black label and not YG, yada yada yada, whatever, it's the same thing, I do want to mention it really quick because it's another way of YG trying to cover up everything going on in their company with women. I need to discuss it real quick. So Somi released Birthday yesterday, which is her first digital single, her debut digital single, which first of all, I wanted a physical album so I could support her physically, but you know, whatever. Second of all, it only has two songs on it. The first song is Birthday. The second song is, what is it called? Editing Carolyn, tell me what it's called. I've heard both songs. I've heard Birthday multiple times. I've heard both songs multiple times. I want to say, first of all, that Birthday is not a good song. Sorry. It's not. I'm sure it's charting well. That's fine. Somi deserves success after everything that she has been through and debuting on such an awful day in an awful company. I'm not mad about her doing well. I'm mad that I don't like the song. I'm sad. It sounds like something that if you were to put ITZY and Blackpink in the same same group and add in a lot more English, and then like decide last minute, we don't want this song, it's not good enough to be a title track. That's what Birthday sounds like to me, which again is sad. I've waited for her debut for so long. She's my bias in IOI. I was so excited for her debut. I really wish if she was gonna go with this kind of concept, this is the concept she wanted to do, she should have just debuted with ITZY. I would pay like big money to know if she was supposed to debut with them and then she decided she didn't want to, or her father I guess decided she didn't want to, or if she was never included in that lineup to begin with. I would pay like good money to know that information. Yeah, so that itself was a thing. And then last night during Sam's Live, because I had been at work all day, Thursdays are super long days for me, so I came home super late and deep cleaned my bedroom because it's a disaster always on Thursday nights, and I was off today. Obviously, I'm off today. I'm not wearing scrubs. I was listening to her live while I was cleaning, and then I was editing for a while. So I was listening to her live during that, and Somi's showcase was a disaster. So not only is the song not good, I mean, whatever, that's objective, but not only do I not like the song, I thought her showcase was a joke. Like, after watching, not to compare other groups, but after watching so many showcases from so many different groups, including AT's showcase literally 2 days ago or 3 days ago or whatever, and seeing how professional and how prepared they were for that showcase after doing so much the past couple of months, like literally since the beginning of the year, they have been working hard. This is their second release of the year. They just did a world tour. They came back with a flawless showcase. Somi goes down to her showcase and she's like, the choreography, I know you saw it in the music video, but it's not ready to perform. So instead of doing that or singing my B-side, which I like the B-side a lot more, by the way, or singing my B-side, I'm just gonna like stand here and laugh and like be cute. And that's okay, right? I was like, how are you kidding me? And I know this isn't entirely Somi's fault, because I'm sure YG like is absolute chaos right now. So I'm sure in the midst of her preparing for her solo debut, something happened. But then I went and watched the music video again, because I'd only heard Birthday once and I decided I didn't like it. And I was like, you know, it's Somi. Let's give it another chance. Let's listen to it a couple more times. I still don't really care for it that much. It's a classic YG sounding song, but I do enjoy the music video. I will say I think Somi makes the music video good, and I prefer the song very much with the music video because of Somi's like extreme personality and stage presence and all that. Like, she's just so incredibly talented, and I'm just so sad that this is how it worked out for her, and I hope better for her in the future. That showcase, man, was a disaster. I could only watch about like a minute and a half of her trying to like play off the fact that there was no choreography. And again, I watched the music video and there's lots of choreography in the music video. Like, there's lots of choreography in the music video. Like, there's no like nothing to piece all that together. It's not really that difficult to choreography from what I've seen from the music video. But, and she does a really good job in the music video with that choreography. She seems really confident, like she knows the moves, like she knows what she's doing, which is important for music videos. So like, what, like, you're gonna perform on stage this weekend, right? Is she performing this weekend or next weekend? I don't even know what's going on. Yeah, I think that that was just such a sad, it was a sad day for YG. Well, pretty happy day for YG. I mean, Yeon Hyung-suk left and Yang Min-suk left, and it was, that's a great time. But for Somi's day, like, I'm just so, again, would pay good money to know what happened between Somi and JYP where she left. Because if this debut had happened in her JYP, at least, even if I didn't like the song, at least she would have been ready for her showcase. Like, you know, JYP would have, any other company would have prepared an idol for a showcase. So yeah, that is all I have to say about what's happened with YG in the past 24 hours. I'm going to go. Let me know what you think of this down in the comment section down below, and what you think is going to happen next. Do you think that they're going to elect the new CEO and then maybe do investigations? Because if there's a new CEO, like this person, it's like when South Korea got a new president after their old president was found to be like super corrupt and involved in tons of different things. When they got a new president, you know that that person has to be like super good and has to be the right person for the job after something like that happens. I feel like we're electing a new president again. That is all of my thoughts on what's happening in YG Entertainment. I am going to have a strong drink tonight in celebration of YG. I wanted to have a strong drink when I woke up this morning. I was like, it's 7 a.m. We shouldn't do this, but I feel like celebrating. This is a big day. It's a good step in the right direction. I feel like there's hope in K-pop, at least in YG Entertainment. And yeah, so let me know what you think about this down in the comment section down below, and I will see you guys very, very soon. Bye.